Welcome everybody. Well, I promised a heavy haul DLC. You getting it? I probably should have taken the other Peterbilt to do it, but we're going to do it with this one. Escort vehicles and all. So, let's get underway.
Beginning route navigation.
Hope everybody's doing all right. Your friends and family are doing all right. Let's take a look around outside of this bad boy. I found a headache rack with some lights on, so let's get underway, because this puppy is 77,000 pounds going to Sierra Vista from Phoenix. And there's one escort vehicle. I believe he'll probably be bringing up the rear. Taking a look at the map real quick here because I don't remember how they had me going, and sometimes it's gonna be a pain either way I go, so I guess I'll go their way. Thing about it is, okay, I still get the 12 lease escort. I got my flags and everything, my banner out front. You can only do maximum 40 miles an hour with this load. Find out where it's going. This is
continue
Sierra,
straight.
Sierra Vista. Doesn't say where down there. When we get there, I know it's on the map. But this red light up here, we won't stop at. You don't stop at red lights in these escorts. It's just kind of nice.
Take the left turn ahead.
182 miles.
Turn left.
There's
the right lane, then turn right.
Oh, they won't be going right.
Turn right.
Weather. This truck doesn't, this is a super long trailer. Doesn't like to turn. So, not only that, every time I take one of these things to Sierra Vista, I end up
take the left
taking out a few light poles in Sierra Vista.
Turn left.
Because this thing is so wide, too. It's not just long, it's wide. See how well that thing overhangs.
Continue straight.
I'm going to be making this turn here.
Turn
kept telling me to try to take it to the garage to get a bigger motor. There is no bigger motor that has the pull power of this one. Well, there is one, but I really don't want to use it because it's a low. Now, you can kind of get these guys to go 40, because that's what it shows in your little speed thing there. As long as you do 40, they'll do 40. Hopefully we won't have a mess up to where the lead car stops. Because you're not supposed to go beyond them. Taking off, even with a normal load, if you don't drop that axle, it kind of hinders your ability to get to speed. And the only bad thing about this is I believe the only place, and I'm not certain, but I believe the only place that I can take these flags and that banner off is in Tucson. ...90 miles back up the road or whatever it is to get there is to get the stuff removed. Okay, I'm gonna keep the headache rack with the lights, though, because I do like the way that looks. And I like to have lights on my truck for doing stuff like this, because adding them all the time is a pain. Oh yeah, what's going on here? Oh, I see what they're doing. I do have an escort vehicle behind me. The problem with these type of loads is if you have to move over, you know, as far as moving another lane, you have to wait for both cars to go over, and that's a little bit of a pain to see that rear one pulling over. So a lot of times I just wait for the front one to tell me to go, see, he's back there. Technically, by real life law, you cannot drive these things at night, but this game does not adhere to that, so I've driven them through the night, don't like it, but I've driven them and delivered them at night. And the nice thing about these is you're only going to pull in one way, and you ain't got to maneuver this trailer at all. In Phoenix, a couple other places that I pick these type of loads up from, and it's straightforward. You get there, you log in, and it backs you up, puts you right onto the trailer already, and then it's just a nice little clip of the truck and everything, and I'll have to show you that next time because it's kind of cool. But yeah, these loads aren't meant to go very fast, that's for sure. Wednesday is my day off, and I ended up getting up at the same time my alarm would have gone. Never get ready to go back over again. Come on, Popo. God, I can't talk to the Sierra Vista. But yeah, my day off in the middle of the week, and I got up time my alarm clock normally goes off, and didn't have to get up, and I was like, oh, crap. My body gets into that getting up at a certain time, and even on your day off with no alarm set, it wants to do what it's accustomed to doing. See, as I sped up coming down that hill, he sped up. So in theory,
keep
you can
left.
Get him to go faster. Well, you can get him to go right about 40. They do have a mod out there that takes out the speed limits, which I don't buy, because you're not going to be going wing and digging down the highway with something like this on your back at 60 miles an hour. It just isn't going to happen. And, you know, now takes out the police car as the lead escort and puts in a lead escort. And I'm like, I don't know. I've downloaded now. Granted, I hear, you know, a lot of people that play this game, you know, they got anywhere from 125 to 200 mods, and I'm not anywhere near that, but
continue straight.
I've probably got about 75 or 80 of them, I think. Most of them being trucks, trailers, and maps. And then with the advent of the sleep time mod that I had, where you can now get 4, 8, or 12, which, okay, you know, I mean, most by law, technically, in the real world, you have to have 10 at some point in time. I'm not going to explain all the ins and outs of 8 and 2 and 2 and 8, all that good stuff. But you can split it up that way if you wanted to. Normally, I just wrote it, you know, 10 and a half hours, depending on where the stops were, and then took 10. That was too complicated to break it up. Plan right, you know, looking for route and everything else like that, you can do it on 10 resting, 11 sleeping, and in that 11, or 11 driving, 10 sleeping, and of course you got the 10 hours off that you have to take, but you got a 14 hour work day, which means if you have to unload a trailer, you can't. One. But a lot of times, 10 hours is sometimes enough to get everything done you need to get done, sometimes not. I mean, I could kill, you know, 2 hours doing my laundry and paperwork, you know, if I had laundry to do. And you still gotta get a shower, and you still gotta get something to eat.
Use the right way, then take the exit on the right.
And then, you know,
take the exit on the right.
Get up. Get something to eat.
Take the right turn ahead.
Make sure that we got everything for next leg.
Turn right. Use the right lane, then continue straight. Continue
and,
straight.
Get it down, you know, that way, but to eat right, sleep right. That's why a lot of trucks that you buy, or you know, even a lot of company trucks are starting to get smart in putting APUs on their truck because of the idle laws in a lot of states, which I think is a great thing, but you know, if you're hot inside that truck or cold inside that truck, you ain't getting the full rest you need. So, you know, a lot of different variables go into 10 hours off. Granted, I mean, I had a small refrigerator in my truck, so, you know, I didn't have to worry about, you know, food, because I kept stuff in my refrigerator, you know, so breakfast, you know, a bowl of cereal in the morning and whatnot, didn't need the truck. truck was usually, you know, if I had to gas up, I did that at night. I tried to make sure that stuff like that was done so I didn't have to cut into my tin. Get a truck to fuel, you do not drop yourself. I think it's on line 4, you put yourself on line 1. Off duty, off, out of the truck. You know, 15 minute slot, but hey, that's 15 minutes. Granted, you're fueling up once 30 hours, roughly. At least every 24, you know, because a lot of companies have gone to that where you can only fuel up. Every 24 hours, so I
continue straight.
But I didn't do it that way. I usually get, usually run 1,200 miles on tanks. That would go to empty, so you never went to that many on empty.
Continue straight.
I mean, you get 1,000 miles out of a tank easy. Of course, then, you know, you're getting hit with extreme costs. Loads too, where you couldn't run any more than half a tank fuel, maybe 5/8 at tops, because the load was too heavy, and that fuel, full tanks of fuel, would throw you over. So I always made sure when I scaled it out at the beginning of the load, I had at least half tanks. Depending on the load. Because fuel only is about 8 gallons or 8 pounds a gallon.
Continue straight.
To the end here, guys. A little bit backing up you can do. All right, let's decouple. Okay, 182 miles. Right on the money there. 10 hours, 15 minutes. 38.9 gallons of fuel consumed. And that'll round out this trip. Take care of yourselves, take care of everybody else, you know, take care of your friends and family. Don't forget to hit the subscribe and like button, the bell for future video uploads. Until next video, guys. Bye.